Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, I am going to be fitting a set of heated grips from Oxford to the Project SV1000. As you can see, the bike itself has already had a set of these heated grips fitted in the past, but obviously in the accident that this bike has endured, it's been absolutely destroyed and no longer works. So what I need to do is obviously remove all the old stuff, get it back to completely standard as if there was never any fitted, and then what we'll do is we'll fit the new ones in their place, and hopefully they'll work as intended. Okay, what I need to do first is obviously remove the tank and the seat. Okay, as you can see, tank's off, seat's off. I'm not going to go through the hassle of taking the tank off. You've seen me do that a couple of times now. Okay, right, wiring for the grips. As you can see, here it all is. I've disconnected it from the battery when I first got the bike, to be fair, to take it out of any equation where it wouldn't start. Now, it's all tucked in. And here, as you can see, is where it all connects up to the actual grips themselves. In fact, interestingly enough, one of the grips has actually come out of the connector. So let me try and recover the wire. Where is it? There it is. Right. That is the right-hand grip. As you can see, they're marked L and R. So the right one's actually completely pulled out of the connector in total. So the right hand grip was never going to get hot in a million years. Right, what we want to do is obviously remove all of this wiring. Remove all this wiring because this is all surplus. What I'm going to do, I could, I suppose, reuse this piece because I am fitting an identical set of grips. But I've got a brand new one, so why not? What I'm doing is I'm just unwinding it from around the loom that's here. That's interesting. What's all that? Terminated ends, right. Okay, don't need that bit anymore. And these bits all come through the headstock. So what I'll need to do next is pull them through. Okay, the cables that come from each of the grips and go through the headstock come down behind this clip here. Into this bunch of wires. So in order to get them out, there's a 10mm bolt that just bolts this clip onto the side of the frame, and it's just down here. Push the forks to one side and you can get in. It's just there. So take that bolt out and the clip should move out of the way and allow us to get all the wiring in from behind it. Alright, let's pop that off. And there we are, as you can see, we've got loads of room now. And it also goes around the clutch line. But we don't need to take it off the clutch line, we can leave it on there, it's fine. All we needed to do was be able to get into these wires. There's the ones that we're talking about. So, if I pull this out now, we should be able to get it out. And there we go, there's the left one. Now the right one is tie wrapped onto the cabling for the switch gear. So what I need to do, get a set of pliers, stick the little tie wrap, and then we should be able to pull that one out as well. There we go. Right. Pull this one through. This one actually comes in from this side of the frame, and there's the two connectors, minus their plug. So get that out, and there we are. Right, now the controller part, as you can see, is free to move as well, so we can just pull that through as before. and there we go. And that is that. That is pretty much scrap. I'll probably keep the connectors because connectors like that always come in useful, but for the most part, the rest of it's for the bin. Okay, what I need to do next, take the bar ends off, and then we can cut off the grips. Okay, bar ends just held in with the machine screw. Remember, of course, that they're JIS, they're not Phillips, so get a good quality JIS screwdriver. As you can see, JIS fits in there perfectly. If I get a Phillips, not so well. As you can see, you've got these little ramps just on the inside. You can see the differences between the two, and that does not fit all the way in. So if you use a Phillips, you just round the sucker, so try not to. Get your JIS, and there we go. As you can see, this is obviously sustained damage in the fall, along with the rest of the bike. So these are probably gonna get, well, I might actually, maybe I'd clean it up, who knows. Maybe I'd clean it up and repaint it. If not, a little replacement won't go amiss. Okay, well, I'll clean that up before I put it back on. Go, there's the other one again. I'll give that a good clean up before we refit. Right then, next thing we need to do is obviously remove the grip. Now obviously the one on the right hand side is on the throttle tube, whereas the left hand side is mounted directly to the clip-on. So what I'll do, get me trusty Stanley knife out and simply cut down, bearing in mind that these ones will have heating elements inside, so they'll be a little bit tougher to cut through. Okay, right, what I'll do, I'll get these off and then I'll bring you back in when we're ready to have a look at fitting the new one. Okay, old grips off. The left hand one came off really, really easily, just as easily as it came off. It used to spin around the bar anyway. It clearly wasn't glued on properly. And for those of you that have seen the video where I replaced the switch gear, you'll remember that the old switch gear was actually glued to the inside of the grip. It was almost like whoever fitted these overdid it with the glue, but didn't put enough on the actual tube itself. So yeah, that one came off fairly straightforward. This one here, as you can see, I haven't actually had to cut it that far. And if you look here, you can see here, that's where it was, all the glue was. So again, once I got around here, I jammed the screwdriver in, worked it around a little bit, and then again, that one pretty much slid off as well then. And yeah, so there we go. We're now ready to fit the new one. So let's have a look at the packaging and open it up and have a look inside. Right then, so here they are, Oxford HotGrips Premium Sport heated grips. Now these come in several different varieties. I've bought the sports option. There's sports, cruiser, ATV, adventure, scooter, commuter and touring options. I think it's just the actual design of the grip itself. I don't know if you can see the picture very well. It's just the way the grip itself looks. The sports ones have a different like detail, you know, the grip itself is of a different pattern, should we say, and obviously the same for all the others. They're all basically different patterns, and the cruiser one seems to have like a brushed metal end cap on it, because I'm guessing they're not open-ended for bar ends like on the sports bikes. Okay then, so all the specifications are written all over the box. Soft ultra grippy diamond tread inspired by race grips for comfort and feedback. Molded wiring arrangement is both durable and discreet. One piece molded construction ensures unrivaled performance and reliability. Grip design fits the vast majority of bikes, but can be cut down in size if required. Intelligent heat controller, raised and tactile silicone buttons for use with gloved hands. Battery saving mode, turns the grips off if you forget, and handlebar switch bracket included. Okay, now talking about the grip design, it says on the side that the grip length is 123 millimeters overall, but it can be trimmed down to 114 millimeters if you require a shorter grip. I'm going to make the assumption that any shorter than 114 mil, and you will damage the elements inside the grip. So that's worth bearing in mind. There's a little wiring diagram on the side. They're pretty straightforward, as you saw the connectors there marked left and right, and there's literally only a handful of connectors to actually make. There's three of them, and then the ones that go to the battery. So we'll go through that in a moment. Let's get them open and have a look at the insides of the package. All right then, let's pop it open, pop the box to one side. Okay, obviously there's an instruction manual, fitting guide and all that sort of stuff. There's a better example of all the different grip types that you can get: retro, sports, touring, adventure, and you can see the patterns on each one are slightly different. Okay, right. Right, this is the bracket for the controller. That can be mounted on the master cylinder bracket. It's pretty much designed to do so. So we'll stick that on there in a moment. In here, we've got sticky pads, tie wraps. Obviously, we've got a bit of grip glue. Grip glue we will use. The person that fitted the grips previously to my ownership clearly didn't bother. Likewise, the guys that fitted the grips to my VFR when I bought it from a dealership didn't bother either, so I had to redo that. Nonetheless, let's move on. Right. Tuck together. Right. So, here's the controller. As you can see, the buttons are nice and big. And as you can hear, they click. And as I've already got a set of these on my VFR, I know that they're incredibly easy to use, even with a gloved hand. Even using thick winter gloves, they're still easy to press. But obviously, you don't need to use winter gloves when you've got a set of heated grips. You can wear summer gloves and get away with it. That's the beauty of heated grips. It's funny that I've only started using heated grips in recent years. 25 years I've been, or best part of 25 years I've been riding bikes, and never bothered until a couple of years ago. So it's quite weird that I've done that. However, having had a set now, I don't think I'd ever go back because they're absolutely outstanding. Okay, so as I said before, they are marked left and right. This is the left one, and here's the right one. Now, there is a little nub that sticks out, and basically what you want in the rest position, you want this to be kind of in that position there, and then when you pull it forward, it's going backwards like so. But at the same time, what we need to do is make sure that we don't put too tight a bend radius on this cable, because it will damage it. So right, what we'll do, we'll start off by fitting the grips themselves, and then running the wires where they need to be, and then the things like the heat controller and all that good stuff we'll come to afterwards. Okay, one thing that we do need to do, and the instruction manual does tell you to do, is any ray sections on the throttle tube are to be filed flat. Now, the people that fitted the grips that I've just removed clearly didn't bother with that. So what I've got here, I've got a file. All we need to do, it doesn't take long at all, look. Just file them flat so that the whole tube is smooth. That way there's no raised sections, because if there is raised sections, then it pushes the grip out and you're not going to get contact with the glue. So all we're doing is just smoothing off the tube. As it says in the instruction manual, it's probably quite surprising how many people don't bother reading the instructions when they buy something like this. But it does pay to prepare it properly. Right, what I'll do, I'll file all of these little nubs off and I'll bring you back in at the end. Okay, that's all the lumps and bumps smoothed out a little bit on the throttle tube. Now what we need to do is we need to do a dry fit of the grips themselves. Now, as I said before, this one is actually marked with an R, so you can't really get it wrong. And to be honest, if you tried to fit the left one, you'd find it wouldn't go over the throttle tube because it is actually ever such a slightly narrower diameter. I don't know if you can tell. That one goes on there fairly easily. That one won't go on at all. I think that one's 22 mil, that one's 24 or 25, something like that. So, let's get it on the bike where we want it. And I reckon around about there is a good place to have it because it doesn't interfere with the brake lever when you're off the throttle. Yeah, and then when you're at full throttle, it comes up here and you're not on the brakes anyway, so. And then you've got plenty of slack in the cable to go around the fork and then down into the headstock. So yeah, that's where we're gonna be. And that is in roughly the same sort of position as the ones on my VFR are mounted. So I know that I'll be happy with that position. Okay, other side. And this one's a bit of a tighter fit than the one that came off, that's for sure. Okay, Oxford do supply the glue that you need in order to fit the grips. They do specifically state in the manual that this is the glue that you are to use, and that they don't encourage use of any other glue due to potential for it to not act in the manner in which it's, you know, obviously intended. When I had to restick the ones on my VFR, I did use a Renthal version. Obviously Renthal, well known for grips and bars and such, and I have had absolutely no problems with the Renthal glue, but obviously I've got this glue, so I'm going to use it. Right, what we're going to do is, once we've opened the little tube properly, there we go, right. What we're going to do is I'm going to put a decent amount of glue. I've got a whole tube to do two grips, so obviously I can use as much as half a tube on each if I wish. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to put a liberal amount of glue around this end of the bar, which will then be drawn up as I push the grip on. If I put loads up here, all that's going to happen is it's just going to push it up to the end of the throttle tube, and it'll just bunch up here. And I don't really want that, because if it does, it'll stop the tube rotating, because it'll be glued to the housing for the cables. So what I want to do is put a decent amount of glue on so that it will stick . As you can see, it's quite runny, so don't do this in your living room. And then I'm gonna slide the grip on and put it in the position where I want it to stay in its resting place. Okay, so that's where I want it. Let's have a look at the one on the clutch side. Now obviously on this side it doesn't matter too much if I go a little bit over the top with it and it does actually stick to the switch gear, unless of course I do need to take the switch gear off again in the future. But it's not too much of a drama. And there we are, getting it roughly in the same sort of place as the throttle side. And I reckon that will do the job. Okay, now what we need to do with the glue is it needs to be left to set for 24 hours before we can actually use the grips themselves. But what we can do in the meantime, obviously, is do all the wiring. So that's what we're going to do next. Right then, next thing we're going to do is we're going to fit the little bracket for the heat controller. Now, that's basically where it's going to be. It's going to be mounted there. As you can see, it does foul with that slightly. However, it can be adjusted, like so, to suit your bike. Now, what they give you in the kit is 4 bolts and a couple of little spacer collars, like so. So you can fit a spacer collar there, and it will allow the bracket to mount on there nicely. But the bolts themselves that they give you two different sizes. As you can see, one is slightly shorter than the other. And obviously you just fit the one that you need to fit this bike. So what we need to do is undo the mounting bolts for the master cylinder and the clutch lever. We don't use these bolts, we don't need to. These won't be long enough. I don't think they'll be long enough anyway, but obviously they give you the replacements that you require. In fact, if anything, they're actually slightly longer, but we'll see how we get on. We've got options. We've got options for mounting of this. Okay, so yeah, basically what we're going to be doing is we're going to be using these little spacers like that so that it sits like so. So what I'm going to do first before we actually mount it is I'm just going to put this in the vise and bend it into the shape that I want it to be, and then we'll come back and we'll start mounting it up. Okay, so we've got the plate into the shape I want it. Before we actually mount it to the bike, because you won't be able to physically get in there to do it afterwards, is we just want to screw the controller itself onto the bracket using the 4 little screws that they supply, these little 4 little self-tapping screws. And 4. And there we go. So there we go. Now we're ready to actually mount it up to the master cylinder. Okay, so I've selected the 2 longer screws, like so. What I'm going to do, fit the little collars, just like that, and then the bracket goes back on just like so. Let's move that out of the way. Take our master cylinder, put it back up to the bar. Now what I'm going to do is just put them in gently by hand. Like so, and then I need to adjust the lever so it's in the right place, and I reckon that's about right. Just nip them up nice and tight, and there we go. And that is the controller mounted. What we need to do next is route all the wiring. So let's get the rest of the wiring out of the box and have a look at what we've got. Okay, so this cable, what we need to do is we need to route this around the front of the fork. Get it in here, come on, there we go. Right, take it around the front. Like so, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna pop it through the headstock so it comes out by the airbox. And there we go, you can see it just coming down the gap between the frame and the airbox. Let me just try and recover the cable. You can take the airbox off to make this a little bit easier, but it's not 100% necessary. And there we go. And what we'll do is I will tie wrap that to the rest of the loom that comes from the switch gear, and then it won't interfere with the steering. It will, you know, it'll be out of the way of all the steering and won't cause us any problems. Okay, so that's stage one, getting that bit through. Next, what we need to do is we need to run the cables for each of the grips back through. I'll take the right hand one through this side, I'll take the left hand one through that side. You take the little plastic twisty off. Take that again around the front of the fork. Because again, once again, that will also be getting tie wrapped in with the rest of the loom. And it will also be going down behind the bracket as well, don't forget. Pop that one through the headstock, and here it comes down the side of the airbox. Hooking it with my fingers, I'm getting stuck on the snorkel at the moment. Come on. Up you come, stop being a pain. I added it. As you can see, when you've got big fat fingers like me, this job's a bit of a pain. As I said, you can take the airbox off if it helps you. And there we go. We've got it. Okay, so get that down here. Now bear in mind, before we put any tie wraps on or zip ties or whatever you want to call them, we need to make sure that we've got a full range of movement in the steering, because that's obviously incredibly important. So yeah, before we zip tie anything together, we will check to make sure that we've got the full range of movement in the steering. Okay. So, right hand one, let's take the twisty off. And the same again. Now, this one obviously is a throttle one. So, not only do we need to be at a steer, we also need to make sure that we've got the full range of movement in the throttle. So when we twist the throttle back, we're not restricting it in any way at all. Obviously, this will go that way, so it will come back up here. So we should be okay, but it's worth bearing in mind. Nonetheless, take that one, put that through, and inject this in again. Have a bit of a mess around trying to get the plug. What I'll do, I'll try and hook it with my screwdriver. And there we are. That was actually a darn sight easier. Right then, so now we have both the left and the right cables down where we need them to be. Now, if we look at the connectors, there's three connectors. Two of them are female, if you will, and one of them is a male one. Obviously, don't get me, don't start flaming me about gender. It's a long-standing thing. But the two grips obviously go into these ones, and it doesn't make any difference which way round they go, because obviously they're both on at the same time. So simply plug them in. They are keyed, as you can see. One of the pegs is square and one of them's got a rounded bottom to it, and likewise on here. Just simply connect them up like so. You may need to wiggle the connectors because they do like to move around inside, and it can be a little bit of an annoyance. There we are. Can be a little bit of an annoyance trying to get them lined up so that they actually lock in place. And there we go. Now this one is the one that goes on here to the battery. So that's what we'll do next. Right then, here we have the wiring for the battery. So basically it goes between here and the battery. This was the bit that I removed off the bike and said that I could actually have probably just left it alone. But obviously we had a brand new one in the package, so why not? So what I'll do, we'll make the connections at the battery and then we'll connect it at this end. So simply remove the screws. And the last one. And there we go. We can always tidy that up later. And then lastly, what we need to do is connect it up. Again, you need to give the terminals a little bit of a wiggle because they do like to move around inside. And there we go. Simple as that. Now you've got plenty of excess cable here, so you can put this section of the loom up any way you wish. It doesn't need to be down the side of the frame, as I've done. It can be absolutely anywhere you want. And what I'll do is I am going to refit one of these little ties. Make use of them instead of throwing them in the bin. There we go. The inside of the frame is hollow, so it's quite convenient. And there we are. That's all there is to it. Now, Obviously, I've got to let the glue set on the grips for 24 hours, so I'll come back to it tomorrow to test, but I've absolutely no doubt that they'll be perfectly fine. And at that point, I will stick the bar ends back on. I do need to give those two bolts good clean, a little bit of Loctite, and they should be perfectly good. Anyway, that is the process for fitting Oxford Hot Grips. Hopefully you enjoyed the video and you found it entertaining or informative or useful. If you did, please give me a like, hit the subscribe button, and I will see you all again for the very next video. Thank you very much, guys. Bye bye now.